Why should you graft a fruit tree? The two main reasons to graft are, first, fruit quality. A loquat grown from seed might not be true to type, producing fruits with small pulp and too acidic. Second, early production. A grafted tree can produce fruit in 2 or 3 years instead of the 8 or 10 usually required for a tree grown from a seed. With most evergreens, the best grafting signs are young shoots that are actively growing. These young shoots are soft at the tip and semi-hardened at the base. Cut a young tip with the required length and remove all the leaves. You may ask a friend that has a good loquat variety to email you a few scions, wrapped in kitchen film, inside a padded envelope. The scions can also be stored in the fridge drawer for a couple of weeks if necessary. You can graft established trees to change varieties or young seedlings grown from seeds. When grafting established trees, prune them aggressively, leaving only a few young branches. Graft a few branches and leave a couple of young branches untouched. Avoid removing or grafting all the branches of the original tree. If the grafts fail, you might end up losing the tree. When grafting young seedlings, remove all the top leaves, leaving a clean area for grafting. You can leave a few leaves below the graft to sustain the young seedling until the graft starts to grow. Check your scions and choose one that has roughly the same diameter as the rootstock branch. I like to use the whip and tongue grafting technique because it has a high percentage of success, but other options can be used and they are also covered later in this video. After making a bevel cut in the rootstock, make an identical cut in the scion. Check both cuts and correct them if they are not identical. Use a sharp knife and try to make the cleanest cut possible, which is not that easy with these young soft scions. With a gentle rocking motion, make a cut in the middle of the scion bevel and a matching cut in the rootstock. Make sure to anchor your grip so the knife has a limited travel motion to avoid injuries. Insert and adjust the scion, making sure that you don't overlap the end of the cut area. You can also use different materials to tie the graft, like the rubber tape I am using in this example. Since the tissues are usually quite soft, you don't have to apply much pressure to ensure a good cambium contact. In this case, parafilm can also be used as a tying material. In windy areas, a strong rubber tape or natural raffia are recommended to secure the graft firmly. Even when using rubber tapes, I like to protect the graft from dehydration using parafilm, a breathable grafting tape. When using parafilm, be sure to stretch it with each turn. This way, the graft buds will have no trouble breaking through this special wax tape when they start to grow. When grafting in late spring or early summer, using a padded envelope is one of the best options to protect the graft from sun and dehydration. Since the inside of the envelope has a plastic lining, it works as a mini greenhouse, keeping the graft protected. Parafilm is not needed if other types of protection are used. Start to open the envelope after 3 or 4 weeks so the growing buds can receive indirect sunlight. Keep track of your grafts by identifying the cultivar. Be sure to include the graft date so you know when it's time to start removing the protection. After 4 weeks, cut an opening on the side of the envelope to check for new growth. If the graft has new leaves growing, widen the opening so they can receive sunlight. The protection can be removed completely after a few more days. Keep the graft tied until the tissues are fully healed, which may take several months. In windy areas, it's essential to use a stake to tie a fast-growing graft, or it will most likely break with the wind. Be sure to remove all leaves and new growth below the graft. If new growth is allowed below the graft, it will soon remove all the sap and the graft will die. One of the easiest grafting options is the cleft graft. It's a simple matter of making a cut in the middle of the rootstock and a double bevel in the scion. However, the cambium contact area is a very narrow layer on the edge of both cuts. If they are not perfectly adjusted, or if they don't cross at some point, the graft will fail. When the scion has a smaller diameter than the rootstock, my go-to technique is the modified cleft graft. Making a cut to the edge of the rootstock allows for a better scion adjustment and graft union. Preparing the scion is a simple matter of making a bevel cut, followed by a small back cut. The backcut allows for an extra cambium contact point at the bottom of the scion, which is almost infallible. Whichever the grafting technique that you choose, most of the grafts will succeed if well protected. After a couple of years, most grafted trees will start producing fruits. The graft unions will fade, and after a few years, they will be almost invisible. This 4-year-old modified cleft graft and these 2 whip and tongue grafts are already difficult to see. So, if you have a loquat tree grown from seed, don't wait 10 years for fruit production to end up finding out that it has an inferior quality fruit. Try grafting it with 1 or 2 good cultivars and you will be glad you did. These videos require lots of time and effort to make. Show me your appreciation by liking the video and leaving a comment. Share the video, and if you haven't already, consider subscribing the channel to help me make more videos. Turn on all notifications on your device so you don't miss my next videos. Thanks for watching.